Good afternoon. Well, what is this newfangled thing?
Can you hear me now?
There you go.
Well, good afternoon, brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon.
I am the Reverend William Haystack Long, and I was born in January 21st, 1852, in Comstock, Ontario. Now, I know that makes me a little bit older than most of you here. As an adult, I became a traveling minister, and I served a large portion of southern Ontario. But when my church asked me in 1883 to become a missionary on Manitoulin Island, I went there and I saw that there were so many missionaries missioning to the natives there. Well, I didn't like the competitive work environment, so that led to my decision to come to the United States and settle my family in Hessel, Michigan. After the move, I began holding non-denominational services in a grove near Cedarville. To get to the grove, I had to walk 2.5 miles from my home to the shore, and after I reached the shore, I had to row another 2 miles to get there. But one day, a man named Milton B. Goff, who happened to be the chancellor of Western University of Pennsylvania, was vacationing in the area and decided to attend one of my services. Oh, we became fast friends. In fact, in 1989, with his friend's assistance, he helped me raise almost $900 to purchase a powerboat. A powerboat in 1889. It's just amazing. But that definitely lessened my travel time to the Grove. After the move, and after I purchased the boat, which I named the Pittsburgh in his honor, I decided to minister to the families that were living on Boyce Blank Island in the Straits of Mackinac. Although the trip there was smooth and my oldest son and his friend decided to come along, the return trip was not. We started to make our way to a life-saving station on the northeastern shore due to heavy winds. But before we could reach safety, we crashed onto the rocks with heavy waves crashing into the boat and our lives flashing before our eyes. Well, fortunately, Captain George S. Cleary of the U.S. Life Saving Service Station spotted us and rang the bell and called for his group to come save us. Within an hour, we were safe inside that station house. While the crew worked to prepare the Pittsburgh and the storm raged on, I chatted with the lifesavers who rescued us. I learned that they received very low pay and few benefits for their acts of bravery and often had to endure long periods of seclusion. Well, from that moment on, it was my wish determined to improve the lives of lifesavers, lighthouse keepers, and their families. I decided that I wanted to visit as many lifesaving stations as possible, so I went along on vessels that happened to be going to or near my destination. If they didn't go exactly to my destination that I was headed, I would finish the journey in a rowboat or on foot. I passed along news, reading materials, and positive stories to those that I encountered. In fact, in 1901, I covered all of Lake Huron and Lake Superior. When I returned home, I recorded those stories of what happened while on my visits, and I created a pamphlet that was just full of positive stories. In 1902, the first pamphlet was debuted, and others called Messages were sent to every single life-saving station and lighthouse in the United States. Later, I decided to purchase a sailboat called Dream, which allowed me to visit every station in the Great Lakes, as well as the St. Lawrence River and portions of the North Atlantic. I also began to lobby for better treatment of these lifesavers, and I worked very closely with Charles E. Townsend of Michigan on a bill that passed in 1915 that not only provided pensions and better pay to lifesavers, but also created the United States Coast Guard. Ooh. I also began to lobby for better treatment of lighthouse keepers to get them the same benefits, doing all that I could to improve the conditions of these brave but very poorly paid men. But that's enough about me. But you can read all about my life in my great-great-grandson's book called Sky Pilot of the Great Lakes. Thank you very much.